Hello! In this video, I will show you how to create an advanced SCL file with Straton. We will start from the SCL we already created in the last video and see how we can improve it. I start opening my project list. I set my project as startup project. And here, with this logo, I can recognize my SCL file we created in the last video. A logical device is already present. Logic and Node.js and LPHD. I start clicking on Create and Add Logical Node. I will choose to add a circuit breaker. I go in this list. I type X. I can see the XCBR. And here, I can see every data object associated to this circuit breaker logical node. In gray are the mandatory data objects, for example, the behavior or even the position. And what is in black, it's what I can add and what is available from the standard. For every data object, there is a command data class. Here, the command data class for the position, for example, is a double point controllable. If I double click on it, I can edit it. I can see that here are the mandatory data attributes linked to this command data class DPC. And I can here edit this command data class or create a new one to add data attributes which are available from the standard. So for example, I can add a new command data class. I will say it's a double point controllable for XCBR, for example. It's based on the command data class DPC. Okay. Sorry, I made a mistake in the name. And then, if I edit it, I can add other data attributes. If I want for this circuit breaker to be able to manage commands, for example, I can add the select before operate data attribute, oper, cancel, OK. I can even see there is the select before operate timeout. I click on OK, and then I can see every data attributes here. OK. And OK. I will add another logical node. I will add, for example, measurements. So I type in the list M, and here I have MMXU, which are measurements. Okay. I can see the mandatory data objects again, and I will add this data object, tot.w, which is the total active power, which have a common, it has a command data class, which is of type MV, measured value, okay? And if I edit it, I can see here there is the magnitude with F, which is a float 32, which is a real. I click on OK and OK. So now, if I edit the initial values for my logical nodes, for example for MMXU, edit DOI, DII, with a right click, I can see that now in MMXU there is .w magf. Okay, so now I want to share these values, which will be accessible from my application, with the outside. It means to be able to send these values with the outside to another server or to an 850 client. I start creating datasets. This is a group of values which will be sent in a report. I create the dataset under logical Node.js. Here I have a button add dataset. And I start saying my dataset here. We'll call it DSXCBR for example. And inside this dataset, I will choose to send the status information, ST, of my circuit breaker. And I will send the position of my circuit breaker. Okay. I will add another dataset to share the measured values. So we'll call it DSMMXU. Okay. And inside it, I will share the measured value of the total active power data object. OK. And I click on OK. And I will also share the behavior of my logical device. So LLN0BH. I add another dataset. Yes, LLN0, for example. I double click on it. LLN0 status BH. OK. Now I configured the set of values which will be sent through report. So now I have also to configure the reports. Let's say I want to send the values of my circuit breaker position to another to an 850 client. As these values are important, I will choose to send it in a buffered report control block. It means that if the connection with the client is lost, values will be buffered. So I start clicking here, add report control block, and I will choose to create a BRCB, buffered report control block. Okay, now it's created. I can choose the different parameters for this BRCB. Among other, I can choose the dataset to which it's linked. So I double click here and I say it's linked to the dataset XCBR. And I have a lot of parameters. I can set, for example, the trigger options for this BRCB. It means that the report will be sent here on data change, for example, on quality change. So if we change the position.queue data attribute, on data update, if the timestamp of the value changes, on period, on general interrogation, okay, and how many reports will be created on the server side. So it means that here, if I set 4, only 4 clients will be able to subscribe to every buffered report control blocks on the server. Up to 4 clients will be able to subscribe. I can let it as it is. Okay. And then I choose also to send my measured values. But for example, let's say it's not that important, so I can send it in an unbuffered report control block. I will add another report control block. OK, I choose URCB for unbuffered report control block. OK, I associate it with the dataset for MMXU. OK, and let's say I want to send it only on a certain period, for example every 1 second, but not on data change, because if it's a float, maybe it will change every milliseconds and I don't want it to be sent every milliseconds, you see. So let's say I want to send it every 1 second. So then in the trigger options, I do not send it on data change, I do not send it on quality change, neither on data update, I only send it on period and on general interrogation if a client asks for it. Okay, and then let's imagine I want to share my logical device behavior. So through the dataset DSLLN0, I want to share it to other servers. So if I want to share that data between servers, I have to use goose report control blocks. So messages will be sent over the goose protocol. So I click on add goose control block here. I can choose goose control block by default. Okay. Here I choose the dataset DSLLN0 and I have to choose also over parameters. This MAC address, I don't have to change it. And I can choose, for example, that the goose will be sent at a minimum time of 100 milliseconds and a maximum time of 5 seconds, let's say. It's explained in the help how it's managed, the minimum time and maximum time. I click on check syntax to see if everything is configured well in my SCL file, and it says that for a goose report control block, an app ID is required. So here I can see app ID. Choose grcblln0 for example, and it says also that for enumerated data types, initial values cannot be empty. Okay, so I double click on the warning, I set a default value. Here I double click also on XCBR, default, okay, check syntax again, and it succeed. So my SCL is now ready. I think to click on save, and I can press, for example, Ctrl-Alt-E to see it in the project folder. Here, I have my id.icd, which I just saved, and if I edit it, I can see everything, everything inside. I can see here that there are additional parameters which can be set in an SCL file. So this is the last thing I will show you. We can set communication parameters and we can set services parameters. This is available through these two buttons, edit communication and edit services. For example, in edit communication, I can see we have different parameters for the subnetwork, address and things like that. And edit services, we have different parameters like the maximum number of datasets which can be configured in the server, maximum number of report control blocks and things like that. Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it and see you in the next one.